Welcome back, and this is question 9 in this series. In this lesson, we're going to try something different and evaluate the answers before we look at the question. I want to illustrate how this technique can be used to help you speed up your question rate in the exam. So let's jump in and get started. Now, this is the full question and the full answers. This is what you might be faced with in the exam. I want to start by asking you to ignore the question for now. Let's just focus on the answers. Let's read the answers together and just identify if there are any which we can eliminate immediately. So forget the question, let's just evaluate what's in the answers. The first answer suggests we use CloudWatch logs to identify database writes and provision an EC2 instance. At this point, we can just stop reading. We don't even need to read the full answer text. CloudWatch logs is a logging, ingestion, and management service. It isn't used to identify database writes, and it can't directly be used to provision EC2 instances. So let's just remove it. It's not a valid answer. And we can remove it even without reading the question. Now, what about the next one? Create an AWS config rule on data in the DynamoDB database. I almost want to stop here, as there isn't such a thing as a DynamoDB database. It's a table, but let's just continue reading to make sure. Configure the rule to generate an event if values change from predefined value ranges. So this is a tricky one. AWS config on the surface can be used to track account changes, but it doesn't have visibility to granular changes in a database table. It's more focused on changes to account level things. So this is a bad answer, and again, we can eliminate it. The answer is suggesting something that the actual product can't do. So this is two answers already we've eliminated without even reading the question. Now, the next answer suggests to create an EC2 instance, install the CLI tools, run a script to constantly poll the table using the scan operation, and run tests against the database. Now, this answer is possible. I have my doubts about its efficiency or whether it's best practice or not, but the answer doesn't self-eliminate, and so we need to leave it in for consideration. By reading it, though, you already have the information in your mind for when you come to read the question, so it's a potentially correct answer. Now, the last answer suggests configuring DynamoDB streams and a Lambda function to run tests. This is another one which is possible. The answer is architecturally logical, so another maybe. So without reading the question, and fairly quickly, we've removed 50% of the available answers. And this leaves us with this. We have a question with two possibly correct answers. So now we can do a review of the keywords present in the question text. The question reads, you are designing the financial platform for a large bank. To detect fraud, you've been asked to implement a system which can run some near real-time checks against database changes to a database table containing account balances. The database is stored within a DynamoDB table in the US East 1 region. So pause the video and then go through the question text and identify the key parts as you see them. Assuming you've done that, let's take a look at what I found and you can compare your answer to mine. Now, the question text has a lot of information which simply doesn't matter. The key parts which I identified are to run some near real-time checks against changes to a database table, and that table is in DynamoDB. Now, we only have two answers with which to pick one correct solution from, so it's a 50-50 choice. By eliminating answers straight away, we're in a situation where it looks much simpler using this approach. So let's do a quick evaluation of the answers, and again, maybe pause the video, have a go yourself, and then you can resume and compare your identified keywords to those that I found. Now, these are the keywords that I saw in those answers. Given what we know and the architecture experience you have at this point, I hope that it's really easy to pick between these two answers. The top answer is just bad. If you see poll using scan, then assume it's wrong until proven otherwise. Firstly, scan is really resource hungry. It checks every item in a table, which for a bank could potentially be billions of items. And secondly, it's a polling architecture, so you're going to have to run the scan operation periodically on the table, which means it's always going to be slow and not real time, or not even near real time. A poll is run periodically, so it's only ever as fast as how often you run that poll operation. Now the second answer uses DynamoDB streams. It's event driven. It reacts directly to data changing in a table and runs a Lambda function. So this is by far the preferred answer in this case, and it's the one which I would have defaulted to even before eliminating those other answers. If you see this type of architecture where you need to react to change in a DynamoDB table, then if there is a single answer which suggests using DynamoDB streams and the Lambda function, you should default to that answer unless you have reason to choose otherwise. Okay, so this question was a little bit different, but I wanted to highlight how reviewing the answers first could speed up the process. Picking between these approaches, so question first or answer first, comes with practice. If you feel like the question would be easier if the answers were validated first, then go with answers first. If the answers rely too much on the question for their validity or not, then do the question first approach. At this point though, I hope you enjoyed this and I hope you got something out of it, but that's everything I wanted to cover in this lesson. Thanks for watching, go ahead, complete the lesson, and when you're ready, I look forward to you joining me in the next.